Upright and breezy today, and I'm not on site to see you, Marcus.
No.
I'm on site to see the learner, which is the other side of the camera, now gone all camera shy. So Marcus has stepped in. You're here to assess today. Is that right, Marcus?
Yeah, I am, yeah.
So we've got a learner in situ in a domestic dwelling, and what are they up to today?
So today on the assessment, they're going to be upgrading the consume unit, and they're also going to be carrying out some remedial work around the home.
Okay, so before we get a ton of comments below about a non-qualified electrician doing notifiable work, how is that going to work for the learner?
So obviously a consume unit upgrade is a notifiable job. Therefore, the QS on his company he's currently working for is going to notify on his bar.
We're hopefully going to see them later on. Probably won't see them on camera, but we'll see those later on. So you're here to assess the learner. I saw the learner when I arrived running around with their multifunctional tester carrying out the test before we started the job. What's that all about?
So he's undertaking some pre-tests. Obviously, we've got certain issues where we've got circuits not on an RCD, and we're going to introduce an RCD protection on them circuits.
So we're checking for low insulation resistance.
We're
also expecting our learners to carry out the air fault loop impedance test before you say, oh, there's RCD. CDs and all the rest. We know that. We're trying to set that standard practice that we carry out all the tests before we start, and then we carry out the change of the board, and then we retest the circuits afterwards, hopefully to remove any issues that we get with the new boards.
Yeah.
Nothing worse than trying to walk out that door, is there,
and
can't get an RCD to reset. So with that in mind, let's have a look at the new consumer unit coming in next. So Marcus, you have to step up again. We can't even get the learner not to be in camera shot when we've only got our hands. Looking at the consumer unit, I don't recognise the brand in the top left-hand corner. Can you tell me what's going on there?
Yeah, so speaking to the learner, he said that he ordered a Lewden board with Lewden RCBOs, etc. However, the wholesalers he got it from, it's actually rebranded as Steeple. Now, it's probably something like Lewden-owned Steeple, and they've rebranded it.
We'll go with that. I like that. So if we just whip the cover off, and you suggested on his behalf that we were fitting RCBOs, which we
type
are.
A.
Ah, we are. Look, you see a little type A symbol there. Brilliant. So we've got those to go into the actual consumer unit itself. However, I did notice when I was unpacking the stuff that we've got one breaker, 32B, which is non-RCD protected. What's going on there?
So basically on this install, there is a small summer house at the end of the garden with a SWA cable running to it. And there's RCD protection in the summer house itself. So we're not going to put it on RCD in the house.
We're also going to fit, and I think we can see just there, the Lewden symbol. We're going to fit an SPD. Well, we're not, they are.
Yep.
So we're going to fit an SPD, and it says, doesn't it, in the electrician's guide to the building regulations, that it should be fitted as close as possible to the main switch. So
yeah, it does
just
say
about
that,
there.
Yeah.
Any problems with that?
So the problem we have now is the bottom terminal is for protective earth.
Okay.
Now, if we had it too close to the main switch, we've got the bus bar.
Okay, so what we're saying there is this bar here, we would have to instantly cut it down because obviously we would be connecting the protective earth onto the line connection. So we're going to end up, I suppose, the learner's going to end up putting it on this end here. Is that
definitely,
true?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's cleared the consumer unit out. So I think it's time to get them on camera and start changing it. And maybe we can just drop in and out and just give a few little tips to our domestic installer learners. So what the learner is currently working on ripping out the old consumer unit, I've been playing around with the new one and I've found something out. So every day is a school day. Once I put the bus bar in position, so I've just loosely put it into the consumer itself and it sits in like so. The manufacturer's left it so we can actually install the SPD on the end. So we haven't even got to cut the bus bar down. We've got the protective earth coming out of here and the line and neutral here. So they've thought about that already as well. Okay, so learners partway through his consumer change. As always, they're desperately trying to make it as neat as they possibly can, but restricted by the conductor length. And just noting there, from slightly different than what we said before, it's a 40 amp feed to the outside summer house, and the 32 amp breaker will be used to feed the SPD. You'll also notice that now the main switch has moved from the right hand side to the left hand side, so there's been some sticker adjustment actually on the consumer unit as well. We'll look at that next. So what's happened here is we've replaced the area here which said main switch, stuck another sticker here saying main switch from the actual sticker pack itself, so you get enough stickers to be able to do those adjustments. So we've used these two here and one from there, so now we've got the main switch actually on the left hand side rather than on the right hand side for ease of eagle-eyed amongst you. We're not finished yet. The QS is on his way. And they're going to sort out one or two bits when he arrives. Just to show you a few bits, if we take the guard away, we only had a piece of 10mm, which is acceptable, 6mm or greater for the protective earth from the bottom of the surge device. And we measured it to be half a metre and we cut it back from that length. So it's definitely under half a metre in length. We're still to wire the top part in, so we're waiting for the QS to come with a bit of cable so we can wire from the 32 amp breaker, the line connection in, and then from the neutral to the neutral bar. And the keen-eyed amongst you will notice the neutral bar now is not quite in the right sequence because we moved the main switch to the left-hand side, and they're going to relabel that as well when they start the testing process. The next part of the video that I want to show all my learners is the stickers required on the front of the consumer unit when you've finished. So there's still some more work to be done here by the learner and the QS. We're now concerned about the actual consumer unit front. So let's have a look at the front of the consumer unit. We've got some of the stickers. So let's pause and think about the other stickers that need to go on the front of the consumer unit. So we definitely need one for two versions of BS7671 because we have both red and black and brown and blue conductors in the installation. The stickers that are currently on here, the QS is bringing the rest of them. We've got the one for the RCD. Important that it's tested every 6 months or half yearly. And then the importance of re-inspection. The date will be inserted by the QS and the re-inspection date no greater than 10 years for a domestic dwelling. So there's one more sticker to go on the front. There is also a sticker that we expect the QS, because we spoke to him already, is going to stick on the inside here of the lid, which has more information about the testing results and the chart information that goes on your testing paperwork. So that will go inside there. Let's lift the lid and look at the stickers that have been inserted to identify each of the RCBOs, as well as the circuit breaker that feeds the surge device. So they're all the stickers in there. So hopefully that's helped our learners for the domestic install, of course, about labelling the consumer unit after the inspection has been completed by the QS. I hope this video has been some help.